Alright, so I thought I would just show a little bit about the other, some curious parts. Like we have both the rim that sits and prevents the carriers from falling off on the outer circumference. Then we have the feet that actually holds up the whole machine. And do use these feet because you don't want the machine to be standing on the servos. These are just a little bit deeper and they go in some of the empty screw holes on the bottom. So when you have the servo sitting in a driver module, you can, and you have everything assembled, you can choose one of the other screw holes with an insert and put it in there, so the machine would be standing on this. You can see the video and general overview of the machine. But that foot is just made up of one of the long M3s, so it's I think M345 or so. And I usually heat up this a little bit with a heat gun to just get the PLA. This is a 3D printed part. It's also in the drawings and CATs. And then I just heat it up a little bit, and you can just squish it in there. I have these rubber feet that just make the whole thing rattle a little bit less, so not to use the table as acoustic plate. And then two screws that are set to some height and counter tightened against each other. I like to use counterfit screws instead of nylock because it's easier to move them up and down and then fit them in the right place. I usually just use a set of pliers and the key to fix that. So now this won't move up and down when I lock it in place in the machine. Alright, and then I'll show you the rim module. It has these inserts, and I figured I'd better show how to put these inserts in. The inserts always come from the open side, so there's always like a 4mm hole and a more tight hole. And that we can see from the... This is the two parts of inserts, or the sort of centerpiece from the switching module. I figured I'd show how to make one of those. So the insert comes with its sort of heat pressed in there, but I actually did a tool because you want this to be relatively accurate. So the tool is also in the CAD files, and here I have these two little nuts that the or two little pins that the inside fit over, so that that's placed in center. So now it doesn't move anywhere. Then I can place this thing on top, and my. And then the insert has sort of a smaller diameter to just set it there in place. And of course we don't want to place it on top of the nuts. Those are there in the corners. Because we want the open hole to move through. I'll just place them both to show you. And then I've set my soldering iron to about, in this case, 265 degrees Celsius. I'll just press this down, and I'm trying to make sure that the edge goes, when it comes down, is moving in, and the edge is sort of flat and straight. You can sort of change that with the soldering iron afterwards. Now this is freehand and standing up and this and that, so you want to get these relatively straight, because then your M3 screws will stick out straight. And just give you a time, don't press a lot, just let it sink in there. Also, if you press too much, the soldering iron will just stick. It's a cone that will stick in the thread. Like so. You can pick it out. And then what happens is that you can get these pileups of acrylic inside the hole. What I did was to take a electric screwing machine, or electric machine, put one of these in the end, and then just run through it to get that. To make sure that that residue you see sitting there comes out. So just run through both holes. So now these are easy for assembly. That's what the same thing goes for the rim. Try to get it sort of accurate. It's not so important for the rim. And then the rim comes together from a few parts. In this case, it's actually the top that has it has these parts. Yeah, and so forth. Quite self-explanatory. Just so, and this is I think 15 or 14 millimeter long M3. Any length would go. Sit there. Two holes for mounting. Those goes over the grub screws. Then you have the offsets here on the sides. Sometimes I need to cut off a little bit of the acrylic in certain cases. But you'd have to do that on the basis of sort of what you need. This one hasn't been cut. Right. Thanks.